Welcome to a blustery but dry at the moment Not Kill Racing Circuit. In today's programme we are looking at round 5 of the Scottish Fiesta Championship as I almost get run over by Barry Farquharson lining up on the front row alongside pole position man and his good friend Wayne McCauley in the number 2 car. I better clear the grid, I'll hand it to Richard and he'll take us through all the action.
Thanks very much Joe. Wayne McCauley and Barry Farquharson on pole position. Stephen Ward and Peter Cruikshank next from Nicholas Forsyth. Then Paul Curtis, the XR2 pole from Christian Leith and Graham Cuthbert. Row 5, Robert Kerr and Philip Liddell. 5 second board being shown. We've had some very long waits on the lights here today at Knockhill. Of course, the object is to keep the drivers guessing. It's another relatively long one, so McCauley and Farquharson have a long wait, as do the rest of the field, and Wayne and Barry indeed lead them away and down into Duffer's Dip for the first time, and it is Wayne McCauley who's got his nose in front. Farquharson slotting into second position. Peter Cruikshank third. Fourth place in black and green is Stephen Ward. The back of the field, we've got Philip Liddell. Keep your eyes open for the black ST, because Philip only had 3 laps in qualifying and didn't get any meaningful laps, so he's going to have to work his way through the XR2s, which are headed by the light blue car. He's already done it, he's already cleared them. They're headed by the light blue 95 of Paul Curtis. Good to see him racing in the XR2s. Christian Leith in red is running in second, but it's Wayne McCauley out front. So McCauley, championship leader, has a very good championship lead as well, comes down into the hairpin at the conclusion, or towards the conclusion of lap number one. We've got all the STs now clear of the XR2s. Paul Curtis heading those, but Christian Leith looking fairly good at the moment in second place. Graham Cuthbert is third, and then Robert Kerr in orange. Robert is second in the XR2 championship standings. So all relatively settled at the end of lap one, so good sort out, no major dramas, which is good. Could set us up for a nice round 9 of the championship. Round 9 means that we are now into the second half of the season. 16 race campaign for the Scottish Fiesta Championship, including that away day that I referred to at Alton Park. That was our last visit, and hopefully you were joining us for that coverage. And here's the view from Stephen Ward, 55 car, rejoined us at Alton Park. He did the opening 2 races of the year, 6th and 4th places with us at here at Knockhill on the 9th of April. So he's looking for a first podium of the year. Great shot. Really shows you how well he holds the outside line coming into the hairpin. Also, the onboard shows you how much of a climb there is. The outfield cameras tend to make the hairpin maybe look a little bit flat, but it's a big climb, not only through the hairpin, but up the hill, over the line, over the brow, down the under the Beatsons Bridge, and then into Duffer's Dip, down into Leslie's. So the 55 car at Duffer's now. Meanwhile, the race leader coming into McIntyre's, and then they'll head into Butcher's Corner. This is a good run again from Wayne McCauley, who has had 3 pole positions so far this year. Peter Cruikshank was on pole at Alton Park. The opening meeting of the year, it was Barry Farquharson. Barry, incidentally, still chasing a first win in the STs. He had multi-wins in the XR2s last year, and you might remember he was the XR2 newcomers champion, but made the move up into the STs. And Wayne McCauley, of course, a very strong benchmark for any driver moving into the ST category. Wayne, a triple champion, was runner-up last year to Kevin White, but prior to that, ST champion 2 years, 2015-2014, XR2 champion in 2013. Sadly, problems for Robert Kerr. Now, that is a shame, because Robert will be losing championship points on Graham Cuthbert. Robert Kerr, don't remember him having a retirement. No, it's his first retirement of the season so far. We're on board with the 55. Off goes Peter Cruikshank. Peter Cruikshank off onto the dirt. Steve Ward goes through. It is, you might have seen spits and spots on the camera, and that's on the windscreens as well, but I'm not sure if that contributed to Peter Cruikshank going off, but he has recovered, and that's the key thing. Philip Liddell is there, and you can see Robert Kerr parked up on the inside line, but it's Barry Farquharson still out front. We're getting the odd wipe of the windscreen from various cars. So it's not wet out there by the look of it at the moment, but conditions could well be changeable. And now we've got Christian Leith leading the XR2. So Christian Leith in front. Paul Curtis in second. Leith double winner at Oult Park. He's going to potentially make it three wins on the bounce in the XR2s. And it's really good to welcome these two drivers into the championship. The blue light blue car, if you remember the name, Paul Curtis, he has raced in Fiestas before. He did six races in the STs back in 2011. And he finished sixth in the table that year. So six from six races. Very good result for a partial campaign. You can see he's getting on the case of Christian Leith again. And also, Paul Curtis was the Mazda champion within the Scottish Saloon and Sports Car Championship back in 2013. Great to see him back with us here at Knockhill Circuit. And what a race we've got on here for the XR2s. Leith coming under pressure from Curtis. And Paul taking a wider line into the hairpin, but so too does Leith, who goes wide, leaves the door open, and Paul Curtis gets his nose back in front. But these two, I think, are maybe going to have a little bit of a rub on the way out. They all know they're not. They sort themselves out. Christian Leith reclaims the lead. Good bit of racing here between the XR2s. Graham Cuthbert still running in third. So Cuthbert, the championship leader, he has 171 points. And we'll move on from that, should he finish. Robert Kurt won't move on because we've seen him parked up. He's on 158. Christian Leith has 70 points from his outing at Oult Park. Remember, Christian was in the STs. So he's got points in both categories this year. Third in the standings is Duncan Fox on 117. I think Duncan may get past this meeting because he's not racing with us, which is a shame. And Duncan, one of the two newcomers, Robert Kerr, the other newcomer. So Robert Kerr will maintain his newcomers lead with Duncan not here this weekend. So Christian Leith putting a little bit of space now between himself and Paul Curtis in the XR2s. So a change for the lead, and it's Barry Farquharson who leads. Now, I mentioned earlier on that Barry hasn't had an ST win so far, and this could be his first one. Wayne McCauley down in second, and Barry Farquharson, who's been very, very consistent indeed. He's been on the podium in all the races. Worst result for him, race one at Oult Park, where he finished third in class. Here is Graham Cuthbert, the XR2 championship leader, coming through shot. And that shot being held as we get first and second overall, with Barry Farquharson still there. You can see not too far away is Stephen Ward in third position. So Stephen looking like he's going to bag a second podium of the year. So Barry Farquharson still out front. Wayne McCauley has got the fastest lap of the race, a 1 minute 2.4. So just a shade over the 60 second lap here. And they go on to the penultimate lap of the race here at Knockhill. And it's Farquharson still out front. Wayne McCauley a little way behind and trying to reel him back in. Barry Farquharson must have been wondering if he was going to have the chance to win a race with Wayne McCauley showing some superb form. But at the moment, the number 18 looking very, very good indeed. Heading up to try and pass Graham Cuthbert. Graham still, remember, running in the XR2s. Third position in the XRs for him. And he'll see the leaders coming. He'll be reminded by the marshals with the blue flags as well. And Farquharson moves to the inside line. Good driving from Graham Cuthbert, who pops it on the outside line, allows the two leaders to go through. So no interference at all with the race leaders. And Barry comes for the penultimate time through the hairpin and climbs up the hill. See the last lap board from the starting gantry as he gets up towards the brow. Keep your eyes on it. We should see it pop out now. Indeed, it is in fact out there. So onto the last lap here. 1.267 miles to go for Barry Farquharson. I tell you what, he's probably a little bit nervous now about this first win coming in the STs, but he's driven superbly. Started well off the front row of the grid. He kept Wayne McCauley on his pop through and got the lead. Wayne McCauley, though, still has got the fastest lap. Barry Farquharson has had one fastest lap so far. All the rest have been with Wayne McCauley. Barry's coming in round three. And he's still there, up into Clark Corner for the last time. And you can see the third place car, Stephen Ward, just going past Graham Cuthbert. Christian Leith is still leading the XR2s at the moment. But Barry Farquharson still there. I was just thinking, was Wayne McCauley starting to reel him in? He isn't. And Barry Farquharson, if anything, has managed to extend the gap at this stage of the race, and he's going to take that first win in the STs. He's climbing up the hill with Wayne McCauley the championship leader behind him. There's the checker. Congratulations, Barry Foxon, on a first ST win. Wayne McCauley second. Stephen Ward takes third place. There is Graham Cuthbert, who is third in the XR2s. And the XR2 battle continues. And it is Christian Leith in red who's going to take a third win on the bounce from Paul Curtis. But he's found some competition here. Paul Curtis takes second place. So let's have a look at the result confirmation here. It's Farquharson's win from Wayne McCauley. Then Stephen Ward and Philip Little. Nicholas Forsyth in fifth. Christian Leith winning the XR2s. Paul Curtis next from Graham Cuthbert.
Barry, finally, well done. It was looking like it was mission impossible at one point with Wayne, but what a great drive and a clean move as well.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I didn't think the gap was there. I didn't know what way Wayne was going to turn in, but I'm glad that it paid off and the first place in the end, first time in the ST for the first place, so really chuffed and speechless about it.
And you're still good friends?
Still good friends, yeah. Well, I was thinking about being my birthday today, it was a birthday present, but no, he did make my work for it, so happy as hell.
It's not over yet, you've got to get ready and do it again later on.
Yeah, so I think we'll maybe be nervous on the second race, but we'll just see what it is.
Well done.
Thank you.
XR2 winner, well done. A double at Alton, which I missed, but your first win at Knockhill kickstarts the year for you.
Absolutely, first win ever at Knockhill, so it's been quite an eventful day. Aye, on to race two. Paul was a bit faster than me in some of the places around the circuit, so we'll have to look at some of that places before race two, I guess.
Good luck, well done. Number two, and on pole position, his first time winner in race one, Barry Farquharson, another surname that I struggle with, but he lines up back on pole position. He's going to be confident of another win, but it was really close with his best friend lining up on the front row, Wayne McCauley. These guys are going to give us a good battle, I'm sure. I'll hand it to Richard, and he'll take us through their final race of the weekend.
Barry Farquharson on pole from Wayne McCauley, then Stephen Ward and Philip Liddell. Nicholas Forsyth on row three with XR2 pole man Christian Leith. Paul Curtis on row four with Graham Cuthbert, the grid completed by Peter Cruikshank and Robert Kerr. Robert Kerr sadly not making the start. Peter Cruikshank is there in the orange and black 61. Lights go out, away we go. Super start by Wayne McCauley from the outside of the front row of the grid. And not so good by the look of it for Paul Curtis. Paul Curtis has been passed by Graham Cuthbert, so it's Christian Leith from Graham Cuthbert, but making amends very quickly is Paul Curtis in the light blue 95, who goes side by side with Cuthbert, challenging for second place in the XR2s. But it's Wayne McCauley, Barry Farquharson, Steve Ward, Philip Liddell is next, and already up to fifth. What a start by Peter Cruikshank into fifth place. He's cleared the XR2s. He's also managed to get past Nicholas Forsyth as well. Philip Liddell will be his next target, so good recovery here from Peter Cruikshank. Through Clark for the first time, there is Philip Liddell. Did well in race number one, fourth position for him. Best result of the year for Philip was third place in round six. So an ST podium for him in round six, and he's obviously keen to try and emulate that again as the lead trio go up the hill to complete lap number one, headed by Wayne McCauley. Barry Farquharson, the round race one winner, the round nine winner, of course. So it's not going to be a double for Wayne McCauley this weekend. A little bit of deja vu maybe for Wayne, thinking that he didn't get the win at Alton Park race one. That went to Peter Cruikshank, rocking the van look from the outside of the circuit. And he looks to the outside line there, all over the back of Liddell at the moment. Let's see whether he's going to put the move in as they come out of the chicane. Both of them riding the curbs in spectacular style. Might see Cruikshank make a move into Clark. No, well, he doesn't. He's certainly teeing up and assessing whereabouts he might be able to go through. It's going to be dependent on really where the 88 car places itself going down into the hairpin. If he goes on the inside, we might see Peter take a wide line in. And no, he breaks ranks, looks down the inside line because Liddell not defensive at all. And through goes Peter Cruikshank. Nice textbook move up into fourth position. And uses the momentum up the hill to consolidate that. Immediately behind is Nicholas Forsyth. We've effectively got two trios of cars in the STs with McCauley, Farquharson and Ward, the lead trio. And of course, Peter Cruikshank will be keen to break the toe from the 88 car breakaway and try and catch up with the three leaders and maybe get in with a shout of a podium. championship wise things didn't really change too much after race number one. 5 points of course more scored by Barry Farquharson over Wayne McCauley, so Wayne on 215 points now, Barry Farquharson on 181. Christian Leith still leading the XR2s, you saw in red there ahead of Paul Curtis, but very close between those two, as indeed it is up at the overall lead, with Wayne McCauley still out front. Graham Cuthbert incidentally extended his lead by another 16 points, 29 point lead now over Robert Kerr, and it's disappointing for Robert, the newcomers championship leader, and he will retain the newcomers championship lead because there aren't any other competitors in that racing today. Here's the view from Paul Curtis, who got his points off the mark. He got 20 points in race number one, 25 points for a win, 20 points for second place. He's got a long way to go to catch Christian Leith, who is ahead of him now in the championship. Leith's got 95 and might possibly overtake Duncan Fox in the third place in the overall championship here in only his fourth race in the XR2 section. Remember, he was in the STs at our last Knockhill meeting. Good battle on for both class leads, though. Look at Wayne McCauley out front, and the fans enjoying some great Fiesta racing here. Are we going to see a move? Yes, we are. Here comes McCauley down the inside, nose in front. Well, clearly in front. So Wayne McCauley loses the lead, but he's going to challenge back. And McCauley there knew what was happening. He knew he had to get on a decent line out of the corner to gain momentum and gain the lead back, which is what he's done as they cross the line. Similar thing happening here in the XR2s. Great battle for the lead. And still there, it's Christian Leith in red, but Paul Curtis all over the back of him. So two races for the price of one in the 2017 Scottish Fiesta Championship. Here come the XR2s. It looks like Leith for the moment is just about holding off Curtis. Starts to build a bit of a lead again, but Paul Curtis, the 2013 Master Champion, will try and close him down again and give us some more entertainment. Here's the fight for the lead of the STs. Barry Farquharson, the chaser. Wayne McCauley, championship leader, out front. If it finishes like this, then the points gap will be the same as it was coming into the meeting, which I guess is going to be relatively satisfactory for Wayne McCauley. But look in third place, Stephen Ward closing them down. As these two squabble, Stephen Ward is getting in the mix as well in the 55 car. Ward bagging a second podium of the year in race number one. Back with the XR2s though, and Paul Curtis having a look again at Christian Leith out of the hairpin past the pit entrance there on the left hand side. Christian Leith, the man looking for a fourth win in succession since rejoining the XR2s. Really good to see him here and holding a good lead. At the moment, Leith took the fastest lap in the XR2s in race number one. At the moment, Paul Curtis is threatening to do that in this one. Curtis, of course, taking pole position. Duncan Fox still has the record for pole positions this year with three of them. Christian Leith taking pole at Alt Park, and Leith under pressure here. Look at that. Fine stuff from the two XR2s. They're trying to close down on Nicholas Forsyth as well. In the STs, what's Curtis going to do? Is he going to find a gap on the inside? More importantly, is he going to be close enough to make the move? And he does actually come out of the slipstream, looks down the inside, maybe too far back. Christian Leith will have seen that and he'll know that he's got this threat. Leith, for my money though, soaking up the pressure well. You know, it's one thing to lead, it's a difficult thing to build a lead, but it's also a major task to fend off when the mirrors are full of what Christian will know is a champion driver. As we said, Master Champion for 2013 loses out a little bit. Now Leith looks a little bit quicker over the hill and down into Duffus and into Scotsman. Is our onboard again from the second place man in the XR2s, Paul Curtis, chasing hard through the chicane. Now down into the Brabham straight. Curtis running a little bit wider, maybe using a bit more of the track, as perhaps we are now seeing a little bit of defensiveness maybe from Christian Leith. So Curtis closing in again. Where's he going to make the move? Battle for the overall lead here in the STs, really hotting up. You can see Stephen Ward has dropped away, and Barry Farquharson goes through back into the lead down the inside line, makes the pass once again, but this time Wayne McCauley, for my money, is a little bit further back, and Barry Farquharson wants to make it a double, but McCauley's trying to slot himself up the inside. He's having a better run up the hill. Wayne McCauley over the brow and back into the lead, side by side coming down into Duffus. Now is McCauley going to emerge from Leslie's in lead position, now coming down into Scotsman, through Scotsman corner. So Wayne McCauley has got the lead back. What a battle we have had at the head of both classes. Super racing from the Scottish Fiestas. They're coming up now to towards Graham Cuthbert once again. Graham still running in third, he's the XR2 championship leader, but Wayne McCauley will be looking in his mirrors here and trying to guess what Barry Farquharson's next move is going to be. Barry's moves thus far have been down the inside, and Wayne keeping it a little bit defensive. He's just keeping up. There's a really making Barry Farquharson look round the outside line. They're going to make their way up the hill. We look for the checkered flag, and it's Wayne McCauley that hangs on. McCauley takes the win. Barry Farquharson second. They're equal on points from the meeting. Peter Cruikshank has closed down on Stephen Ward, but has to settle for fourth. Meanwhile, Paul Curtis still challenging Christian Leith for the XR2 win. It looks like Christian is going to hang on to it and make it two out of two here. Four wins in class on the bounce. Here we go up to the checker. Christian Leith takes it. Fourth win in succession. Paul Curtis is runner-up again, but Paul getting the fastest lap in the XRs. Here's the result. Wayne McCauley, Barry Farquharson got fastest lap and second. Stephen Ward next. Peter Cruikshank, Philip Liddell, Nicholas Forsyth, Christian Leith, XR2 winner from Paul Curtis and Graham Cuthbert.
Wayne, well done. Putting things right in your mind to Barry there. You had to beat him this time, or it was going to be a long drive home.
Yeah, I wanted to beat him that time. It was probably one of the best races we've had, because we kept chopping and changing, mostly at the hairpin, but I kept getting a cut back on him and getting back in front. But it was always probably the best race I've had this year so far. So
is that the help that you're giving him now stopped?
Definitely.
He's getting too quick, eh?
Yeah, definitely.
Well done, Wayne.
Cheers.
Barry, well done. First race win in the first one and a close second there. Things are looking tight towards the end of the season.
Yeah, I thought I was going to maybe have it in the bag there, but near the end, the tyres were just absolutely wrecked. And that's probably been the best race me and Wayne have had together all season. So hopefully I can live and learn and try and get back on top step again.
Well done.
Thank you.
And the second XR2 win of the day. Well done. Some close company from your teammate, shall we call him, Paul there?
Absolutely. Paul kept me honest right till the bitter end. I thought he was going to stuff up the inside of me at the hairpin, but I managed to keep him out. So the double-double, I'm happy with that.
And points-wise, it's been a successful weekend. You've made up for a poor start to the year.
Very successful weekend, considering I only joined the championship halfway through. It's a long way to go, but fingers crossed we managed to claw in on Cuthbert and Kerr towards the end of the season with a bit of luck.
Well done.
Thanking you.
Well, unfortunately, that brings today's programme to a close, but what great action we've seen all day long. Make sure you tune in next time for more of the same.